Is wall punching a red flag? My 21F BF 21M gets so mad playing games he'll punch stuff. He's broken a TV, a door, and put two holes in a wall in the past 2 years. It's weird because I would never consider him to be an angry person. He's very even-tempered, much more so than me, I would say. He just gets really competitive at games and takes losing really personally, or so he's said. I've talked to him the other times he did this and he's ashamed and embarrassed of it every time. It just really bothers me. He's never hit me and I don't think he ever will. I've been in an abusive relationship before and this definitely isn't that. He doesn't punch stuff when he's mad at me, just if he loses a game and is mad at himself. I've asked him to get therapy before and he can't afford it. He doesn't have insurance and we unfortunately live in America. He'll delete the games for a while or stop playing, but he's been playing for years and years and doesn't want to just stop because he can't control himself. So he'll start again and be good for a while, but then it happens again. Is this a red flag? Should I be worried? We were supposed to move in together in the fall, but I don't want to have to pay security deposits or worry about him destroying our house. I've told him that before too and it stopped him for a while, but he just did it again. What do I do? Edit. Wow. Did not expect this to blow up. I know everyone says that, but seriously. Thank you all for your input. I'm staying with him, for now. But things are definitely gonna change. I'm gonna get him a punching bag, as many of you suggested. We're looking into cheaper therapy options or getting him student insurance through our university. We had a long talk about it and he's fully willing. He has other mental health things he needs to work through too, and we think addressing those as well as his anger will make a huge difference. Not going into all his traumas, but he has a very low self-esteem sometimes when it comes to certain things, and he likes winning and video games is a thing he's good at, the only thing he feels like sometimes, so when he loses it's really personal for him. We won't be living together until he's made progress though. For those of you worried about my safety, thank you so much. As I said before, I don't think he'll hit me, at least not anytime soon, because as he describes it, he gets mad at himself for losing and just overall hates himself a lot. That being said, I am on alert for any other behaviors. I also don't think it's a manipulation tactic, because he absolutely never does it in front of me and is so embarrassed when it happens and would probably rather I not know at all. But I'll definitely also be bringing it up with my own therapist. And for those asking, it's Call of Duty, Apex, and Mortal Kombat, lol. I'm not a gamer, so I've never experienced the, emotions that arise from those games, but I'm sure that matters to some of you, haha. It sounds like he doesn't have good coping mechanisms for strong emotions, which doesn't bode well for a healthy relationship. That this keeps happening and he doesn't try to address it is, I think, a deal breaker. I'm a recovering angry person and yes, he's got anger management problems. Today, a video game, tomorrow a road rage incident possibly involving serious harm. I know the cost is high without insurance, but would family and friends take up a collection for it? Call around and ask some of the therapists what the cash price is. You'll find it's not that bad. I use the Talkspace app and it isn't too bad as far as pricing. A good place to start is to get some books on the subject. He needs to learn the difference between reacting and responding to things that make him angry. Reacting is that sudden tantrum type behavior he's exhibiting, and responding would be taking a pause and trying to understand what happened and figure out a solution. Tantrums aren't solutions, and without solutions, the problem never goes away. He needs better coping mechanisms for his emotions, and he likely shouldn't be engaging in a hobby that generates these levels of negative emotions in him. Gaming is great and all, but when someone starts crying over lost League of Legends matches or punching walls over getting spawn camped, it's time to put it down. Can you tell us about how he broke the TV and the door? We were supposed to move in together in the fall, but I don't want to have to pay security deposits or worry about him destroying our house. I've told him that before too and it stopped him for a while, but he just did it again. What do I do? I wouldn't get an apartment or house with someone who engages in emotional destruction of property either. This is a reasonable and responsible financial decision, beyond whatever red flags you're considering. It's up to you if you want to be in debt to your landlord after the boyfriend knocks down a wall or kicks out an expensive window fixture. Speaking as a former wall puncher, yes, it is a red flag. If he can't play video games without getting so angry that he destroys his property, he shouldn't be playing video games. Now, video games are almost definitely not the problem. But I say this so you can see how silly the "I just get worked up over video games" excuse is. If something makes you crazy, stop doing it. If your boyfriend destroyed things when he got drunk, people would say, "Sounds like someone who shouldn't be drinking." It's the same logic. You are absolutely correct in thinking that it would be foolish to get on a lease with him right now. I'm not going to tell you that he's a danger to you because I don't know that, but destroying shit is enough reason not to move in with someone. It is a red flag whether or not it escalates to attacks on you, because you deserve to be secure in your property. And destroying shit around the house is scary, upsetting behavior. There's no need to frame it as, "Oh, but at least he isn't directing this rage at my body." That's too low of a bar. Girlfriend says that she prefers if my family tries to speak English when we come over. Okay, cool. But how TF am I supposed to fix that? My parents don't speak English, barely a lick. They came here a long time ago, but never learned English. Only time my parents speak English is when they're trying to mock us, siblings and I. They can understand for the most part, but just can't speak English. So I've come over with my girlfriend maybe 4 times, and she often feels really left out. I translate what they're saying to her, but she still feels left out because everyone else would be laughing / talking and she's just sitting there waiting for me to translate back. This week, my parents are coming over to my house. She asked me that she wants me to tell them to try to speak English. I sarcastically said that I'll hook them up with Duolingo, and she said that'd be great. Bro, I didn't think she was being serious. She doesn't think it's reasonable for them to come into our space, even though it's my apartment, but that's a convo for another day, and for her to still not understand. Feel for her, it must be frustrating when you can't understand anything. But how the hell am I supposed to get her to understand my parents? Even if my parents did speak English, she still would not understand them because they don't speak the language, so they don't form sentences well. I can't even understand them when they speak English. Because we are all about helpfulness here, this one goes out to you /status_target 5679. My parents have been in the US for 23 years. No, they still don't speak English well. Yes, I'm aware they should speak English. No, I'm not mad at my girlfriend for asking. I'm just confused on what she wants me to do. If I read that X needs to make more of an effort to learn X, I'm gonna implode. Do people think that Op has any control over who in his life learns more of another language? Only thing you can do is decide if the relationship is worth it, cause it will never be easy. My advice: have a conversation with your GF about how she feels. Sometimes it just helps to know that your partner understands that it is hard on you. Hopefully she can understand that just like you can't demand she learn Japanese, you can't demand they learn English. Also maybe make clear what their true capabilities are. She may genuinely not know how little English speaking ability they have because their understanding is good. I'd also consider having a chat with your parents. Just check in, see if they ever feel uncomfortable about not being able to easily communicate with her. My husband's family had horrible guilt about this, making it even more of an obstacle. One thing that helped me was that my grandparents-in-law just gave up on my husband's translations and tried to speak very slowly for me. Of course, I still didn't understand and had to get a phone out. There's a verbal translation option on Google Translate, or wait for someone to help. What that did though, was show me that my husband's family wanted to communicate with me. That helped me to feel included. Something I did was manage to find a joke, one word, that got a laugh out of them. Again, it was me communicating directly to them, making them see that I wanted to communicate with them. It literally took me almost 10 years to get a few members of my husband's family to try and speak with me. A lot of them had a little bit of English but didn't feel confident enough to speak. Once everyone understood that I was not going to ridicule them or impose English classes, they came around to using what English they had. Hopefully this helps. Good luck. I'm a native English speaker and my wife is Japanese. She is the only one in her family that speaks English. When I first met her parents, it was incredibly awkward. There was a massive cultural and language barrier there. For English speakers, learning Japanese is one of the hardest possible languages to learn. I have no idea how my wife did it. She is a brilliant woman. My Japanese is still meh. Thankfully, my in-laws have been accommodating to me. They dumb down their Japanese and speak slower and more clearly for me to understand. From time to time, they even attempt to speak in very broken English for my sake. That being said, if she is truly bothered by it, then she needs to buckle down and study. Talk about getting massive brownie points from your parents too. I understand how she feels. My ex's family spoke a foreign language and I constantly felt left out and uncomfortable. Everyone is laughing and having a grand time while I sit staring blankly. It put me in a bad mood, and when he'd translate, I'd have a mundane response or try to fake something. It's really an awful thing to experience, but it's quite unreasonable for them to start learning English like that. You can't expect either party to learn the other language if they don't want. At the least, tell her how it makes you feel when she's like that around your family. Have a good discussion and hear each other out, cause she clearly isn't having it. If she wants them to speak English, she should try harder at learning some basic phrases in your language. Even then, she'll feel left out. My ex didn't like when I didn't look happy or laugh when he'd translate something funny that was said, cause I just didn't get the context. Even if he told me, I was just like, oh, okay. If this prolongs, it's possible she'll start thinking you should find someone else who speaks the same language. There's no way she'll feel any connection to your family, like she's just another person there but invisible. Tough situation. As they understand English, the compromise here is that you should speak more English yourself when talking generally / broadly when your GF is listening, i.e., when not talking directly to one of your parents, and then they can answer you in their language and if appropriate you can translate for your GF. This always worked with my wife and her parents in group settings. Of course, it's unreasonable to ask them to speak English, but not to want English spoken more in conversations, and you are the only one with the tools to help facilitate the situation better. If your parents spoke English and were intentionally not speaking it in front of her, I'd understand. That would be rude. But if they legitimately don't speak English, it's not really an option for them to speak English, obviously. Has she tried to learn your language? She's tried learning it in the past way before we started dating, and she could never get the hang of it. I, 30F, live a double life. I'm exhausted and want to come clean. For the past 3.5 years, I have been living a double life. It started when my aunt, who raised me, got sick, and I told my husband, of 9 years, I wanted to move in with her so I could care for her. He was against it and told me he would hire carers to look after her for me. My husband knows how close I am to my aunt, so I was furious he would even suggest something like that. I ended up telling him I would go no matter what he said, especially since I already felt neglected and unwanted in my marriage. And it seemed like my husband was only staying married to me to keep up appearances. He didn't really fight me on it after that, and I moved in with my aunt. I have built a whole other life for myself here. I work part-time, something my husband would never let me do before and something he still doesn't know that I'm doing. I have some really amazing friends and my aunt is doing much better. After 9 months of living with my aunt, my husband told me he expected me to attend an event with him. I didn't realize just how unhappy I was in my marriage until I felt the dread of having to see him and potentially his family again. I did end up going for 2 reasons. I was letting my aunt believe I was extremely happy in my marriage because I didn't want her worrying about me, and I didn't think he would take no for an answer. When we reunited, my husband kept commenting about how I seemed different, and he wasn't treating me like someone he was being forced to bring with him for once. Even though my marriage is much better now, it still feels like I live a double life. I play the happy housewife when I'm with my husband, who dresses and behaves a certain way, and then I'm the complete opposite when I'm with my aunt. It's exhausting and things are awkward whenever my husband visits my aunt because I don't know which me I should be. It also doesn't help that my friends don't know I'm married, and I know my husband wouldn't like them. I don't want to feel like I'm living 2 different lives anymore. but I don't know how to merge them. What do I do? How do I stop being two different people? Too long didn't read, dash I live with my sick aunt and travel to visit my husband occasionally. I now have two very different lives and two different versions of myself, but it's exhausting maintaining both and I want to stop.